Hello everyone, today I want to talk with you about really interesting things. It's about where is the tales came from. I know some of you going to be disagree with my opinion, and if you have another kind of knowledge, you always can share it in the comments. I just want to share with you my opinion, and it's totally fine if you are disagree. But I really hope you find it informative or at least interesting somehow. So let's start.
In the modern world, there is a large number of religions, but most of them are borrowed. Back in time, our ancestors saw another world in front of them. They believed in other things that we now call mythology. But let's be honest, it was more than myths. This is what created our cultures. These beliefs were different around the world and depended on so many things. On the weather in places where people lived, on habits, on the flora and fauna around. Some believed in desert spirits, some in forest creatures, others in an old woman that's stealing the kids, and some in the fact that the souls of our ancestors live in us. These were magical beliefs that created the individual folklore of each country. Our ancestors took these myths and transformed them into stories they could tell to the children, to give them knowledges about the world that exists around them. Centuries later, writers took these oral stories and changed them, wrote them down and spread them all over the world. With the adoptions of other religions, rejection of past beliefs has come. Characters that were previously on the side of the forces of nature now begin to be perceived as evil. As a person from Russia, I will take the tales of my country as the basis for my narrative. I can say that all the tales that I heard in my childhood had a mythological basis. I'm sure some of you have heard such a character as a Baba Yaga. In tales, she appears as an old wicked witch with bone leg, stole and eat little children. But if we will look deeper into mythology, we will see that this character is not as simple as it seems. Baba Yaga not only guarded the border between the worlds of the living and the dead, but also was a conductor of a dead souls to a new world. And one of her legs was bone because she stood in the world of dead. Her house in Chicken Legs in tales was shown as a magical structure which had no windows and doors, but as it was said in the fairy tales, it could turn. If we will turn to mythology and history, we will see that in north of Russia, the dead were buried in Domovinka, houses located above the ground on very high stumps with roots looking out of the ground. That is actually what was looking like a chicken legs. Domoviny were set in such a way that the hole in them was turned in the opposite direction from the settlement to the forest. People believe that the dead fly on the coffins. People treated their dead ancestors with reverence and fear, never bothered them, fearing to incur trouble, but in a difficult situations, they still came to ask for help. The mythological image of the hut on chicken legs watchtower into the realm of the dead. So, as you can see, Baba Yaga is much more interesting character than we used to think. The same things happened with all the characters in all tales around the world. They had deeper roots and meaning. In fact, all tales are modeled myths that change their meaning and narration over time.